Well, welcome back to Steve Rob Reviews. Today, we're going to have some fun, and I think I'm going to save you a lot of money if you don't know about this. Now, if you do know about this, it's always good to share with your friends, like I'm doing today. Okay, where do I get started here? This is my Milwaukee circular saw, and it says on the tag, 15 amps. Let's take a look at the tag just to verify.
Well, there you go right there, right at the top right-hand corner, says right there, 15 amps.
Okay, I'm back. What do I got here? Hunk of wood. I got three extension cords here. The two blue ones were 100-foot cord. I made two 50-footers out of them, and they are 12-gauge. I got a 100-foot extension cord in the middle. That's 14-gauge. This one over here, number six. That's for my 220 welder. So I can weld out in the driveway. Over here, each 100 feet. So what are we doing here today? Buddy of mine across the road come over and says to me, Steve, can I borrow your circular saw? I said, sure. I'll give you an extension cord. So I went to get my 50 footer, number 12. He said, no, don't worry about it. I got an extension cord. I said, well, what's wrong with your circular saw? He goes, I'm pretty hard on circular saws. I burn them out like every second, maybe third year tops. I got to buy a new circular saw. So I'm going to get a new one this week. I just need to cut some more wood up here. And I said, well, hold on a second. You're burning them up. I mean, I don't even hear this guy hardly even use his saw. But he's cutting up skids, and he's cutting up old 4x4s, and he trims his tree with a circular saw, this kind of stuff. So I said, let's go over and take a look. Hold on a second. Because I don't like lending out my stuff. I usually, you want my circular saw? It comes with a power cord. I go over there, and he's got this 18-gauge, like this. Except this looks nice compared to what he's got. He's got this old beat-up cable like you wouldn't believe. It was just like a rat's nest, just kinks in it, twists and everything else. And I says, like, how long have you had this thing? Oh, maybe 30 years, 40 years. This fella's about maybe 77, 78 years old. And I says, do you ever think maybe it's not the saws that's causing the problem here, buddy? He goes, what are you talking about? And I go, it's your extension cord. And he goes, well, what's a guy doing an extension cord? Well, I'll tell you what. He started telling me he's no longer going to buy a half-decent circular saw anymore because he just burns them out. This guy is so good at working circular saws, he burns them right out. And I'm thinking, buddy, it's your cord burning it out. Maybe a lot of people don't know about this. We're going to do a little bit of a demonstration, and we're going to show you exactly what he did that was wrong that could save you a lot of money. So let's take a look at some readings here. I got my meter set up, got my clamp meter down here, and all I'm going to do right now is I'm going to plug the end of this cord in, I'm going to zoom you in, I'm going to plug this in, and let's just take a look and see how many amps this 15 amp circular saw draws. Let's get to it right now.
Okay, so here we are right here. I got the circular saw plugged in directly to the outlet through the splitter. And the clamp meter is going to register amperage on the right and voltage on the left. They're both set at min max. I'm just going to pull the trigger and let's take a look at the readings. Well, I can see a maximum of 43 amps on the left. Let's take a look at the min max. I've got to manually function it. There, went down to 109.8. And there it is, 119. So here we are here. We got that 100 foot 16 gauge plugged in. Let's go over to the meter. Meter on the right is amperage. Meter on the left is voltage. Let's pull the trigger. Let's take a look at the readings. Wow, you can see a big difference. The amperage draw was only 34. Let's take a look at the voltage. And I don't think you're going to see much of a difference. 111.
which I suspected. So, as you can obviously see, there is an effect there. Now, let's cut a piece of wood, and let's just leave that 100 footer in there, and let's cut a piece of wood like he was doing. Okay, you ready? I'm just gonna cut into this 4x4 like he was doing. Okay, so there you can see the results right there. And we're down to 35 amps. And let's take a look at the voltage. Down to 111, didn't change much. 35. Now let's put the regular power cord back in and let's cut another piece of wood again.
Okay, so this time here we've got the circular saw plugged in. Let's go over to the meters and let's take a look.
Let's just cut another slice.
Well, we're looking at 38.
Let's take a look at the voltage. 109. And you could see how much it was binding at the end there, going through a little bit of a knot. But you can definitely see that there is a difference. Well, could you notice a big difference there? And here's the two spots there, and you could see the second one was going right through that knot. Guys, I'll tell you something. That cord that he had, I would not want to try in this because all it would do is just burn out the armature on my circular saw. This here is just a test to show you that, yeah, if you want to use a circular saw or anything that says on it 15 amps, it's really not 15 amps, especially when you really start working it. All you're doing is you're not providing the full power to the saw itself or any other electrical tool that you're using. And it's best to have a setup like this where you can test first, because if I would have lent my saw to him, I guarantee you it'll probably work that day for him, but my saw would be damaged for sure. It would just be arcing like you wouldn't believe inside there, not running at its full speed and its full horsepower. And that's the problem that I have seen and I've noticed with a lot of homeowners and do-it-yourselfers. The first time they say, can I borrow you know, your saw, yeah, you give them the extension cord to go with it. And most rental companies do that as well. If you go to a rental company and rent one of their pieces of equipment, they want you to use their cord because they know that you're going to take it home and you're going to have this old, hedge cutter of a extension cord that's just all ratty and knotty. And when you have an extension cord and it's very old, a lot of the wires inside do break over time. So you think you got a 16 gauge extension cord and it's probably like a 20 gauge by the time all these different, conductors inside have broken over the time. Because his was so knotted and ratted, you would not believe it. So I just thought I'd make this little bit of a demonstration here today to show you, yeah, it's best to test your equipment like this if you can. If not, just look in the manual and it will tell you what gauge cord and what distance you can use. And I see it time and time again, with my neighbors around here and some of my friends that want to borrow my tools. And I say, no. You have to have the right stuff because it may not break down for them while they're using it, but it's going to break down for me, that's for sure. So thanks for joining me here today and I hope you found this interesting. And if you've never seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. Come back again. Let's have some more fun. Hey, let's do some more testing like this. Cheers.